Hello, it's Leontine from Little Lovely Crafts. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you're back, thanks again for stopping by. Today I'm sharing an alien camera card featuring some really cute alien photos. I roughly traced the inside of the sort of like Instax picture frame and I am stamping some aliens with my stamping buddy. I'm using my Memento Tuxedo Black ink a few times to get the right black lines. I'm repeating the same process of tracing and stamping with my stamping buddy for the other two pictures as well. I used a full stick post-it note to mask off the spaceship so I could easily stamp on the alien, and I also added some stars. I messed one up, but in the end you won't see it because it doesn't come high enough in the pull tab mechanism, luckily for me. On my third photo, I'm using two aliens and I'm stamping a little flag into the hand of one of them. I was trying to figure out if I needed some more stamps in the scene, but I decided to make a whole scene with my Copic markers instead. To keep my video interesting, I'm only showing you how I'm coloring one photo because the process is pretty much the same for the three of them. As I said before, I'm not using any ink pads, I'm just using my Copic markers and I'm trying to blend the colors as best as I can by going from light to dark and back to light again. If you're not really interested in watching me coloring, you can just skip ahead to about 5 minutes and 13 seconds. We'll be right back. And this is my finished result. The little scene I've created here is that one of the aliens is coming home to his planet in his spaceship, and he finds out there is a little surprise party going on, and the two other aliens are greeting him, and then they take a selfie together. Now I'm just going to add those white frames on top with some liquid glue. Off camera, I die cut all of the necessary camera parts, and I used some sugar plum cardstock for this. And for some reason, my die didn't cut the entire lens part out, but that's just fine. I used a little painter's tape on the back to keep it attached, and it saves me putting a white piece of cardstock behind it. I used some storm cloud cardstock to cut out the lens part and some white cardstock to fill in the little shapes in the middle. And I also used storm cloud cardstock for the button, and I used some white cardstock for the flash. I used a blue sheet of paper from my Really Rainbow Christmas pack, and I used my largest large stitch rectangle dies to cut it out, because that is the size that the Magic Iris pull tab add-on dies line up with. This is actually the first time I'm using the pull tab add-on for the Magic Iris camera, but it's surprisingly easy to use. I die cut the pull tab part with some sugar plum cardstock as well. You don't really see it because it's behind the photo, but I wanted my arrow to have a purple color as well, so this was the easiest way to do it. And of course, the cardstock is sturdy. As you can see, I'm using score tape to attach all of these pieces, because then I know it is attached really well. Once this is all attached, I can gently slide my photo through the camera and see if it works the way I want it to work. And I'm snipping off that excess of the pull tab, and I'm decorating it with a piece of the same paper as the background. Since I haven't put a piece of white cardstock behind the camera, I'm using a little bit of purple painter's tape, and then I can attach my little red light on top of it. And I'm using chili pepper cardstock for the little light. I don't want the flash to be just white cardstock, so I'm using my Copic sketch marker Y quadruple zero, and then I am using my Nuvo Aqua Shimmer Glitter Gloss Pen to add some shimmer to it. To decorate the front of the card and give a hint that it's a space card, I'm using some planets from Out of This World, and I am stamping them with clear embossing ink, and I'm using the Wow Wanderlust powder because it has a sort of clear glitter effect, and I really love how it looks on that sugar plum cardstock. I have to stamp everything in phases, so I'm stamping something and then I'm heat embossing it, going back in with the ink and some new stamps until I find that the whole front of the card is decorated. And the cardstock kind of warps a little bit from all of that heat embossing, but you can try to flatten it a little bit by using your heat gun on the opposite sides of where you have been heating it, and you can also run it through your die cut machine without anything on top, and that sometimes helps to get it a little more flat as well. On the sentiment, I'm using the primary ebony embossing powder from Wow. I'm using foam squares to lift up the camera to make the mechanism work. Right here is where I noticed that my pull tab was having a little trouble pushing the photo back inside again, so I wanted to reinforce the pull tab part by adding a little strip of white cardstock on top of it. Instead of using foam squares, I used some foam tape to put on the back of my camera, and then I can attach it to my card base. A little trick I learned from watching others on YouTube is not to pull off the release paper entirely. What I like to do instead is peel off a little corner of my release paper or liner paper, and then I can place my card on the edge where there's still release paper on top. Once I'm happy with it, pull off the entire release paper and then I can press down and my card is in perfect placement. And now I'm going to decorate the inside of my card. I've already told you I'm using those two pictures on the inside, but I also need a sentiment on the inside saying happy birthday. I'm using some Lawn Fawn freshly cut grass ink and I am just placing those pictures at a bit of an angle to get a playful effect. I could have left my card like this, but I wanted to use some more greens because I was inspired by the Butterfly Reflections ink color board, and I decided to use some Nouveau Glow Drops, and I think the color is called Apple Sour, and I just used some dots around the planet and the stars on the front of the camera. It is glow in the dark, but since it's still wet, it isn't activated yet. Anyway, my card is all finished. I hope you like what I did with it. Give my video a thumbs up if you think it was a clear instruction, and I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel. As always, have a wonderful day, and I hope to catch you next time. Bye!